Hi folks, today I'm going to talk about a topic that usually raises a lot of the doubts and generates some insecurity when it came to filling the circuit. This is because when it comes to connecting the plus 50 to the GND from another source, it does not seem like a safe thing to do. And that it's why I always mention in the videos that address the topic the importance of the three energy sources to be totally independent. There are two main ways to connect a VFD. One is when the driver requires a negative voltage, for example the PT6311. The other is when the driver requires a positive voltage, like the case of the SN75518. The second method in general seems to be better accepted by the hobbyists, since it requires only two potentials, in this case plus 5 volts DC, for example, to the logic. Also it can be used to the filament, and the, for example, 35 volts to the tube polarization. So let's talk about the first method, which use three cells to the filament, the tube, and the logical voltage. Okay, this is a small circuit I have done to reuse a transformer belongs to the compact sound system. I removed the transformer of the compact sound system, which have a VFD to allow construct this small circuit, and you can see the transformer have three independent coils in the secondary. The first coil is 24 volts, the second and 40 volts, and the third is 2 plus 2 because it have a pin center. I only use half bridge rectifier, in this case one diode by each coil, and had here a small capacitor. I had here a regulator 7805 to extract 5 volts DC, and I like advert this IC support the input until 35 volts DC. Okay, of course, depending of the current pass through it, is necessary calculating the heating system, because if you convert 25 volts DC in heater, this means you'll need a big sink system. The tube is here, and you can see I don't connect the cathode to anything, because in the VFD tube the cathode is the filament. Okay, the don't have the physical metal to represent the cathode, but the cathode is the filament. Okay, after you have the grid, and after you have the plate, I use two resistors to polarize at the same time the grid and the plate, because I don't implement any control. It's only to exemplify how polarized the tube. Now I like you pay attention to this part of the circuit. Here you can see I have the rectifier, I have the plus of the capacitor, and I have the negative. This means here is plus and this is minus. And note I connected the minus to the center pin of the filament coils. This means these two points, the output of these coils, this point and this, will be referenced to the 50 volts. This means in this point I have less 50 volts, and these two points are referenced to the same 50 volts. This means my cathode is referenced to this point here. This means here I have less 50 volts. And now, if you pay attention, you will see this point here is the plus, plus 50 volts DC, is connected to the VND of the first coils. In this case is the minus of the 30 volts. This means this point here is marked also as a reference to this point. I have here 30 volts, I have here 50 volts, and this point here is a marked as a VND. By this reason, in this point, I have less 50 volts. And now I like you look to the tube and think in a diode system. To correct way to polarize the diode is heavier the plus and here the minus. The flow of the current will be in this direction, okay? From the anode to the cathode. If you look to the tube, you need have here in this point, in this anode, the plus. And look, if you go to drag this resistor here, this point is 50 volts. This means have plus. And if you look to the cathode, okay, you need the negative here because the flow from this point to this, okay, the current will be sent from this point, and here you need a negative voltage to have the flux of the current, okay? In the reality, this point is negative relative to this point. This means if you have here the plus and here the minus, the drug diode or VFD will happen. Okay, let's go make some measurements to the output of the transformer. The three pins in the left belongs to the coils to the filament, and you can see here the 4 volts AC, and this is the center pin, and you can see related to this pin have 2 volts and 2 volts also to this. Okay, these two pins here is the coil of the 40 volts, and you can see here 38 more or less, and the last coils belongs to the coil of the 24 volts AC, and you can see the value here. Okay, now I have a diode here and a diode here. This means if I change this to the first I like show the values of the AC voltage present in the filament pin. In this case is 390 volts. Okay, change to DC, and you can see here in this capacitor 30 volts, and in this here you have something like 50 volts. Okay, and now if you make the connection of the plus here, the 50 volts, and measure here in the filament, you can, this is negative voltage, okay, and you can see here 50 volts. Okay, if I revert the points of the multimeter, you see I mark less 50 volts. Okay, and this happened because this pin here is the middle pin of the coil of the filaments, is connected to the negative of this capacitor. If I disconnect here, you see you can see here these pins in the right side belongs to the grid. Okay, because I charge, I have 14 grids with the last the symbol M and the key is the grid number 15. And if I pass to the other VFD tube, you can see here also the grids in the right side. Okay, this is a VFD from a sound system, and this is a VFD of a calculator. And you can see the right of this VFD here. If I change now to the other VFD, you see the bright is strong. Okay. Also, I like to show to you, because I don't have here any reference, when I connect with my finger here, you will see some variation of the segments. And this is all. This is a transformer here. You have the marker here, the reference, the connections I have done is 2.34 volts, 0 volts, 2.34, 40, and 24. Now, the question the people do it every time is not possible use another things, is not the transformer. Of course, you can do it. Normal, you can use this kind of the small converters, but you need to take special attention to the GND, because the GND of the input power is the same to the output power. This wire is connected to this. This means you cannot use three converters powered by the same 5 volts DC, for example. Okay, if you put here 5 volts, you can get here, for example, 35 volts. Okay, but the question is the GND is the same. This means the converters use the same reference to the GND point. Okay, you cannot do it the power up of the VFD with this kind of the systems for the whole three tensions, but you can use, for example, for the plus the positive voltage. Okay, if the VFD work with the positive voltage, you can use this VFD, this converter, to get 50 volts, for example, or 35 volts. You can use the same 5 volts DC to the input to power up the filament, and one converter powered by 5 volts DC enough to polarize the logical circuit, the filament circuit, and the positive voltage. Okay, you get the positive voltage to the tub through the converter. When you work with negative voltage, this is not possible because you need the power up of this input be independent to the other two points, okay?